Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Hi, everyone. I'm BK Gu from Seoul National University Hospital. Today, I'm going to talk about the Korean, Japanese, and European Bifurcation Club consensus for physiologic assessment. There are several imaging consensus from Bifurcation Club. Unfortunately, there's none about physiology. And that is the reason why we decided to start the project for physiologic assessment for coronary artery bifurcation disease. And the joint committee was established in 2018. And in 2019, EBC board approved this project. And we had a draft review meeting several times. And this year, February, we had a revision meeting between Korean and European Bifurcation Club members. I'm taking this chance to thank all the members from these three clubs for their time and efforts for this joint consensus documents. One interesting question is, why did it take so long for revision? Because we had already revision meeting in 21 February. It's because there has been changes in the concept and or the usefulness of physiologic assessment due to this trial. So we decided to change the philosophy of these documents from physiological assessment to physiological approach. It may be a minor changes, but there is a huge changes in the philosophy or direction of this document. So this document is not to simply advocate for the more use of physiologic indices and not to show the benefit of physiological indices over imaging, but to present the true meaning of physiological approach for bifurcation lesions and to present even the limitations and pitfalls of physiological indices and also present the practical algorithm of applying for physiologic indices in daily practice. It is interesting to see that the first step in this algorithm for physiological approach is not with the physiologic indices, but with the clinical relevance. We know that the side branch territory is highly variable, as in this figure, from 2.7% to almost 18%. And the meaning of FFR is totally different between these two vessels. So the clinical relevance is first, and that's the essential part of physiological approach. So even physiological assessment is not recommended in small vessels. And even the measured value is low, that does not always mean the benefit of revascularization. For large branches, we have to assess the procedural risk and benefit before performing the physiologic assessment. We have to admit that the pre-intervention physiologic assessment cannot predict the functional significance of jade side branches, and it is generally not that helpful in decision-making for one stent provisional versus upfront two-stent strategy. We stress the importance of what we want to stress is that the adequate knowledge in interpretation of the results. So if you have a lesion when angiographically significant, but physiologically insignificant, you shouldn't just say, okay, this is common, this is a mismatch. But before you say that, you have to check all these possibilities, risk and benefit assessment for any physiologic assessment, especially for jade side branches, because reported failure rate is by average around 4 to 5%, and mechanism of drilling is mainly on the ostium of the side branch. So we have to recommend the assessment of benefit and risk. And benefit is higher in short ostial lesions, and risk can be higher in heavy calcified and severe tortuous lesions. So you have to make this individual balance for all your patients before you do any physiologic assessment. And we also describe the issues over the FFR versus non-hyperemic pressure ratio. So there can be several differences in the backgrounds and practical application and amount of evidence for bifurcation lesion. But our stance is that the greater priority is for more adoption of a guideline-endorsed physiological-based approach rather than the debate itself over which is a better index to follow the physiology indices, which is the same for the cases with reverse mismatch. angiographically insignificant but physiologically significant, before you make a clinical decision making with these numbers, you have to check all these possibilities and limitation pitfalls of physiologic indices before you follow that number. And we also describe the possibility and limitation of drilled pressure wire technique. So there has been several papers on the feasibility of the drilled pressure wire technique, which is the drilling the side branch pressure wire with the stent and measure the drilled side branch FFR with that pressure wire. So the procedure will be more convenient and easy and maybe safe. However, we have to understand that the pressure sensor window and gaps between the sensor and wire part is different among the branches. And there are several reports that the damage in the pressure wire and even the stent occur during the retrieval of the wire because of these different structure. So our recommendation is this technique can be feasible, but it is very important for operators to understand these different mechanical features of pressure wire and potential risk of damaging the wire itself and stents during the wire pullback. And we also describe the balance between physiology and imaging, especially for two stenting technique. We can say, and we can still use physiologic indices to define the rigid ischemia and also the presence of complete functionally revascularization. However, for the procedural optimization, we recommend imaging guidance more than physiologic guidance because this is more important in patient outcome than the physiological values assessed with the physiologic indices. And we also presented the new approaches and novel technologies. We endorse the physiologic index-guided DCB treatment, which seems to be very promising. And we also strongly recommend to use a co-registration of imaging and physiology, which can review the location of physiologic significance. And for this 001 lesion, the pressure step-up was quite diffuse, so you cannot relieve ischemia in these patients, only fixing the diagonal branch osteo lesion. And we also introduced the several image-based physiological assessment, their potentials and limitations, and also future direction, such as treatment planning using these non-invasive imaging physiology combined modalities. So in conclusion, ladies and gentlemen, this joint consensus documents by Korean, Japanese, and European Bifurcation Club presents the concept of physiological approach as well as the current knowledge, practical tips, pitfalls, and future directions of physiological assessment in bifurcation PCI. This document will guide interventionalists to perform appropriate physiology-based assessment and treatment decision for coronary bifurcation lesion. Final message from the document is that we should be more physiologic than physiological indices. Thank you very much for your kind attention.